How's it going, everyone? Today we'll be looking at the ASUS Prime B660M-A WIFI D4, a micro ATX board powered by Intel's mid-range B660 chipset. Now, the Prime series by ASUS represents a more entry-level series of motherboards in its entire lineup, and it sits right beneath the Tough Gaming and ROG series of boards. This B660MA WIFI D4 motherboard, therefore, serves as more of a budget-oriented Intel B660 offering by ASUS. Do note that the D4 in the model name means that it supports DDR4 memory instead of DDR5. Let's get started. As always, let's start with the packaging. The ASUS Prime series of motherboards all come in a grey and white box, and this board is no exception. Now, if we were to move over to the rear of the box, we get the usual overview of specs for this board, nothing really fancy here. We'll cover the board specs in depth in the next few minutes of the video. With that, let's get cracking with unboxing the board. This being a board with built-in Wi-Fi, ASUS has included a Wi-Fi antenna, naturally. Setting aside the cardboard divider and motherboard for the moment, we see that the B660MA WIFI D4 comes with two standard SATA cables. We also get an I/O shield, which indicates that this board does not come with an integrated I/O shield design. Apart from that, we get a pack of M2 drive screws and standoffs. And this is accompanied by a M2 rubber pad, which adds additional height clearance for you folks out there with single-sided M2 SSDs. We also get an old-school DVD driver disc. And this is accompanied by a quick setup guide right here. And to round things off, we get a motherboard manual. And that concludes the contents of the box. Now let's move on to take a look at the board itself. And here we have it, the Prime B660MA WIFI D4. ASUS has gone for a liberal amount of white stripe motifs on the PCB, which lend themselves very well to the silver heatsinks for the VRM area, M2 drive slot, as well as the chipset heatsink. Do note that the board does not come with an integrated I/O shield design as mentioned earlier, nor does it come with built-in RGB LEDs of any sort, though of course there are onboard RGB headers, plenty of them in fact, which I'll cover later on in this video. The VRM heatsinks are a standard aluminium affair, which are unsurprisingly really small as compared to those that you see on higher end boards. The passive heatsink for the B660 chipset is pretty small as well, but that being said, I'm pleased to note that ASUS has included a M2 drive heatsink, which definitely enhances the appearance of the board on the whole. For memory support, the B660MA WIFI D4 comes with 4 DDR4 slots instead of DDR5, and it has support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR4 5333 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single tab design. The RAM slots boast ASUS's Optimum 2 technology, which improves memory stability and compatibility. Right next to the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header and a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C front panel connector. While on the topic of USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses a bunch of USB 2.0 front panel headers and another USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header. In terms of expansion slots, you'll be pleased to note that this entry-level board comes with a PCIe 4.0 x16 slot with the ASUS Safe Slot feature, which reinforces the slot. It also comes with two full-length PCIe 3.0 x16 slots, with one of these slots supporting the X4 mode and the other slot supporting the X1 mode. In the storage department, ASUS has included 4 SATA 3 ports, with 2 in a right-angled configuration and 2 in a straight-angled configuration. For M2 slots, it comes with dual PCIe 4.0 X4 M2 slots, which is great. For audio, ASUS has included a Realtek ALC897 audio codec, which is a very standard audio codec that can be found in most lower-end motherboards. Internet connectivity, on the other hand, is courtesy of Intel's i219V chip, which supports gigabit Ethernet. Now, while we've got to bear in mind that this board is an entry-level offering after all, it would have been a welcome addition had this board come with 2.5 gigabit Ethernet instead. Moving on, wireless internet connectivity is powered by Intel's AX201 Wi-Fi 6 part, which also provides support for Bluetooth 5.2. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 4 fan headers, which are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 addressable RGB headers, a surprisingly generous amount, in these areas, as well as a 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the B660M-A WIFI D4 goes for a traditional I/O layout without an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 connector, dual HDMI 2.1 ports, a PS2 mouse keyboard combo connector, 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, an Ethernet port right here, and this is accompanied by Wi-Fi and 10A connectors, as well as your standard audio connectors. You'll also have noticed that the board comes with a rather non-standard CMOS battery, which is attached to the side of this I/O port stack here, and it connects to the board via a 2-pin battery connector like so. And with that, the B660M-A WIFI D4 is an interesting offering in that it pairs legacy features with the latest tech. On one hand, you get future-proof features such as support for the PCIe 4.0 standard for your graphics card and M.2 drives, and on the other hand, you get legacy features such as DDR4 support, a PS2 port, and a whole load of USB 2.0 ports. In that regard, perhaps ASUS could have done with more rear I/O USB 3.2 ports instead. Also, I'm not a fan of the CMOS battery arrangement for this board, as replacing it isn't going to be a simple drop-in affair that you get with the normal type of CR2032 battery holder. As of April 2022, the B660M-A WIFI D4 can be had for a price of around $289 Singapore, or approximately $160 US on e-commerce platforms such as Newegg. With that, thank you so much for watching. You guys know the drill, boop the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.